The last five shots were a bad idea.
So,
going to have words with your commanding officer after this.
Why do they call it a monorail? It's a train! A train!
Have half a mind to throw you all in the cell and let you
sweat it off. What's up, Mr. Holdout? You sound look like an interesting dude.
Hey there, friend. A bit of advice. You look like you could use some protection. Lucky for you, I got what you need. My stock in trade? All kinds of easy-to-hide weapons for slipping into and out of casinos. They won't give you a second glance.
Why would I need to hide a weapon on me?
Simple. You can't bring guns into the casino, that's why. They'll strip you to your fists. Sure, they say you get it all back when you leave. Me? I don't like being without a little insurance when it's my caps on the table.
I can get weapons past the guards, no problem.
You might. One fella I knew was able to slip a pistol past the guards. You? I'm guessing you could get a machine gun by them.
Let me see what you have.
Take a look at these beauties.
Now, this guy's Mr. Holdout. He will sell you different weapons that are called holdout weapons. In the casinos, in the strip, they will take you down. They will take all of your guns unless you keep your holdout weapons, which is smaller weapons. But there are
look alive,
if
guys.
You have
NCR time.
25 sneak, you can bring in a pistol.
The monorail was just ahead. Somewhere.
But if you have 50
so
sneak,
up, I can't feel
you
my
can
legs.
Bring in what's called advanced holdout weapons. Advanced holdout weapons are bigger guns that are still smaller, like a submachine gun or that kind of thing. You can bring those in. Heck, a power fist, I think, is considered a holdout weapon, just so you know. So that's why it's good to have. Like, the nail gun's considered a holdout weapon, if I remember correctly. The light shining in darkness is, too. But I'm going to go talk to Victor here, because you had
some. Well, howdy, partner!
I'm not ready yet.
See?
Okay, I'm gonna go make everyone wait here, because if you don't, they're just gonna go wander off. Whoa. Wait here. Good boy. Raga, wait here.
Should've brought something to read.
Boone, wait here.
I'll sit tight.
Eddie, wait here. Good boy.
Well, howdy, partner. Good to see
you. Thank you, Victor. If you have everybody in, now, forget where your partner, your companions get in. None of your companions can get in the bottom floor, and I think they can get on the bottom floor. He'll explain it. Victor will explain it here, if I remember correctly. But before that, I'm gonna go loot some stuff, because there's a bunch of stuff that I could loot, some of it I'm not worried about it. But it is one thing, because, like in Fallout New Vegas, in Fallout 3, I always, well, you guys didn't see me play Fallout New Vegas, but M3, but what I like to do is I like to grab every unique weapon, and there's a unique weapon in here called the Golden Gloves. So, they're unique, copies of the Boxing Gloves. So, the thing about Boxing Gloves, though, is that they don't really do the damages. They're down here, aren't they? Yeah. It says inflicts fatigue damage. It knocks out people. Basically, what you do is you knock out people.
Yeah.
So yeah, you just knock them out. It's non-lethal. It's for like if you're going past this run. So yeah, it's not that great of a weapon, but they're there and they're free. They're easy to get too. So. Talk to Victor here.
Where to, partner?
All right, we're gonna go to the penthouse apparently. So Mr. House wants us, huh? Eesh. This doesn't sound feel right to me, does it? Does it, guys? Ooh. What?
Penthouse floor.
Whoa! What the? Who the heck are you, Jane?
Well, hello, sugar. Mr. House is waiting for you in his office.
Okay. What's with the robots with the snow globe collection?
Not many people know this, but Mr. House is one of the world's biggest collectors of antique snow globes. If you happen to find any out in the wasteland, you can bring them to me, and I'll add them to his collection. You'll get a reward, of course.
So this is...
In fact, one of Mr. House's favorites went missing when we moved the collection. If you have a look around the Lucky 38, you might even find it.
So, I've got a snuggler for Mr. House's collection.
You do? Why, that's just wonderful. I'll take it and put it with the rest of the collection.
So yeah, this is what they use the snow globes are. This is why you find snow globes in the DLCs technically. So enjoy your time in Vegas. They're basically the bobbleheads of this game, so all they do is get you money. And apparently this is Mr. House. So nice modeling work here.
This meeting has been a long time coming, hasn't it? You've come a long ways, literally, and I suspect figuratively as well. I have to ask, now that you've reached your destination, what do you make of what you see?
A city devoted to vice and sin. I prefer a wasteland, to be honest.
You aren't going to ramble on about the virtues of life out in the wastes, are you? It's a desert, you do realize. A radioactive desert where humans subsist in a barbaric state. Difficult to glorify convincingly. They are, however, aptly named. For that's what you'd be out there, wasted. Here on the Strip, your talents can be put to use.
What are you talking about? I'm just a courier.
Oh, don't be coy. You've been playing a high-stakes game ever since Victor dug you out of the ground. Don't be afraid to admit it.
I don't know what your business is, but let's get down to business then.
The business is this. One of my employees has stolen an item of extraordinary value from me, and I want it recovered. Simple enough.
I'd like to ask some questions.
What did you wish to know?
What terms are you offering?
My only concern is the recovery of the Platinum Chip. What happens to Benny, I leave to your discretion. When you bring the chip to me, I will pay you 4 times the delivery bonus stipulated in your contract. How's that?
It's a good start, but well below market price.
Very well. 5 times the bonus. Not 1 cap more.
1250 caps? I accept your terms. No, I can say the chip is worth far more than that.
My offer far exceeds the original terms of your contract, which, I will remind you, already obligates you to deliver the chip.
I'm gonna take him off. Still not interested.
You have an interest in this, whether you like it or not. You signed a contract to deliver the Platinum Chip to me. Now, I could stop you from leaving, but what would that accomplish? See what the Strip I built, the Strip I own, has to offer.
Oh, okay. I can go and talk to him and get Benny. I don't really care. I'm not working for Mr. House. I don't know, does he still comp me? I don't know if he still does this, but...
Congratulations, partner. The boss has instructed me to comp you to the High Roller Suite. You can bring your friends, too. Be like a little clubhouse for the gang you put together. Just bear in mind, you're the only one gets to see the boss. Any friends you got, they can wait in the suite. Enjoy the digs, partner. They're plenty fancy.
So, we can go to the cocktail lounge. Presidential Suite's your home. It's basically like the Megaton House, but it's craftier because it's harder to find. So, yeah. Because it's harder to fast travel to, because it's not like Megaton where you just like, oh, fast travel, boom, boom, you know, you just go through the loading screens. You don't. It's kind of annoying. Like that. Is this the one I already alluded? Okay, well, anyway, around here should be that one snow globe where you, yep, there it is. Snow globe test site. I got this, what? What did I get for the snow globe that I get? Okay, that's wrong. It should be the Lucky 38 one. It should be the Lucky 38 snow globe. That's weird. So yeah, I can go work for Mr. See, when you do this, there's three different things you can do. You can go work for Mr. Work for Mr. Vegas, work for the NCR, work for Caesar's Legion, or work independently. And I'm gonna be working for the NCR because if you don't, it's kind of like the happiest of the endings, in my opinion. And I have never beaten this game. I've played it to death. I've played it. I know it inside and out. I've just never beaten it. And I'd rather my first playthrough be NCR. So.
Hey, you there. I have a message for you. It's from Ambassador Crocker. Very important.
Okay, so that just tells me I'm supposed to go to the embassy. There's an embassy here, yeah. This house owns this place. It's kind of like a separate country.
Aw, just...
What? And you get strip fame.
I've got your bet.
The strip would be technically be, Mr. Crazy. House. And now they're all gonna be like...
I thought nobody has ever been inside that place.
That one must be important around here.
Check that out. She just left the Lucky 38.
Damn, and she looks good to me, too.
Oh. I'm already taken, thank you. Veronica's already my lesbian lover.
It's hard to sleep in this place, I tell you.
So, yeah. What's up? Yeah, you can actually gamble at the casinos like we did at the Sierra Madre. I'm gonna be doing them off screen after I go take care of this NCR business, because I don't want my 7 days thing going off. So, yeah. Camera shake! Ah! And the NCR. Hey, soldier.
Sounds like we're running prim now. I'd still rather take my leave at the strip.
Yeah, the prim's not that great. Sadly. Soldier. Soldier. Hey! He's throwing bottles at me. It's kind of weird to have like an embassy here. It just doesn't feel right that they should have one. And Rocker, if I remember correctly, is this way. The rest is like offices and stuff. Mr. Crocker?
I'm glad you could make it. I have something I wanted to discuss with you. It's a very important matter, and I have a strong feeling you're the perfect person for the job.
I'm listening.
I'm sure you've noticed that things are a little tense around here with all the issues between the NCR, the Legion, and Mr. House. It doesn't take a genius to see that something big is going to happen soon. To be honest with you, the NCR is in a tight spot. But if we fail now, it's the people here that are going to suffer the most. I'm not willing to let that happen. And I don't think you're the kind of person that would either.
You have my attention. Go on.
To the northeast is a settlement. The locals here call them boomers. They are sitting on a munition stockpile that would be invaluable to us. I would like you to get in contact with them, and then do whatever it takes to convince them to help us. Unfortunately, the boomers keep to themselves and are, let's say, hostile to all outsiders. That's why I need someone like you. Someone with your background and reputation would have a better chance of reaching them than anyone I have available. In exchange for your help, you would receive complete amnesty for any past crimes against the NCR, as well as additional benefits and perks. Do you think you would be able to do this for me?
I'll find them and talk to them.
Much appreciated. Once you've talked to them, come back and let me know if they will help us.
Let's see here. Goodbye. You can play caravan with them, that's interesting. So. Now, does that mean... Let us check. I don't know if I have to go and do the quest first. Wait a minute. No. Ah, jeez. Neutral with the strip.